This is the island of Hawaii, the spiritual center of the archipelago, where our young Iwa will spend 2 days visiting Kilauea, the home of Pele, where they will see the flora, fauna, geological features, as well as being introduced to Kawahine Okalua, the Lady of the Pit. Our young ones will gather for their huaka'i to kumukahi, and then proceed to Kilauea, as was done by so many young Iwa in the past. Only this time, it will be Aloha Airlines, not sailing canoes, that will carry the group to Hawaii. As part of their development, the children are asked to pack themselves with supervision. Each class will gather at the far end of the Aloha Airlines terminal, where they will be met by their teacher, trip coordinator, and academy counselors. Once everyone is present, the huaka'i begins by passing through security and into the waiting room, where campers play quiet games led by their academy counselors. Transportation from Kumukahi to the volcano is provided by Kilauea Military Camp in their spacious new buses. After a quick snack and a visit to the Volcano Visitor Center, the class is off to hike through some of the most pristine environment on the planet. Students are eager to share what they've learned and practiced about a particular feature found on the island.
Lots of people use the berries for leis, and the Nene love to eat these berries. I don't know why, they just probably think it's good.
Vai Vai Ole's nickname is Ratfoot because it's long, skinny bristles. And Vai Vai Ole is a club moss, and a club moss is a vascular plant, and a vascular plant means it has tubes. So Vai Vai Ole has tubes throughout its body.
Would you like some? Yeah, but sometimes we can't.
After lunch, there are educational treasures to be discovered in Jagger Museum, overlooking Kilauea Caldera. Though tired, the students find time to unwind, reflect in writing on the day's activities, and unpack before their buffet dinner.
Okay.
Kawahine Opele is always ready to surprise us with the possibility of a spectacular display of lava, which has been flowing into the sea since 1986. The children sit under the night sky, pocked with stars, as they listen to star lore pertaining to ancient ancestors, legends, Greek myths, and watch for satellites streaking across the mesmerizing sky.
You can see the flow coming down. You see a straight flow. I'm not sure if it's A'a or Pohoihoi, but there's a lava tube that you can see. The lava is coming out over where the smoke is hitting the ocean, and that's Pohoihoi in the tube. Remember how fast Pohoihoi can go. Matt?
Around 35 miles.
Around 35 miles per hour, very good. Some of that is probably A'a flow because it does appear to be moving extremely slow.
Perched at 4,000 feet, our young Eva birds slowly make their way out of their warm bunks, out into the chilly pre-dawn morning to warm up with a little Thai key before investigating the plants and steam vents along Kilauea Caldera's rim.
Exhale down.
Breakfast offers a dizzying array of options to prepare the Eva for an active morning, spent visiting the Apapani and Amakihi near Thurston Lava Tube before proceeding into the tube.
A lot of plants go around the lights. Why is that? Very good. So even in a cave with artificial lighting, you can see there's ferns, moss, lichen.
Nestled in a forest sanctuary in Keaho is a special aviary where the students have the opportunity to see some of the most endangered birds in the world. This is a rare treat for them, and as a result, the fourth grade adopted one of the endangered birds. Namakani Payo is the former site for the fourth grade camp. Now it's a lunch stop where counselors share their memories before it's time to return to Kumukahi, where our huaka'i began. Once again, memories are made and are tucked away like a fine quilt in a chest, later to be unfolded and enjoyed.